Hey guys, it's your boy Pure Bears, and welcome back to my Phase 16 Juventus Career Mode, where last time I left off I picked up wins in the Champions League over Lyon, and in the league over Inter Milan. See, I'm playing the other Milan club, AC, and I also have a league game against Atlanta, but first, as I said, I'm playing Milan. This is in the Italian Cup. Not sure what it's actually called, so that's what I'm calling it, the Italian Cup. Sorry. But yeah. This is, but as you can see, I'm putting out the second day because the Atlanta game is in a couple of days. And there's a second leg to this. But I take to get the job done. Also, it's the first appearance of Jordan Ibe since I signed him on loan on deadline day, so looking forward to playing with Jordan Ibe. Can you begin? Ibe is one of my favorite players in this game. Not because he's
out in force today, as you would expect.
He's just really, really good for a young player. I mean, he grows super fast with the training. It's unreal.
These two teams have scored plenty of goals to get to this stage.
They should be able to play on a wider front.
I am doing one career mode off of YouTube, where in 5 seasons, I got Ibe to 92 rated. 92 rated! I didn't even know he could go that high! I thought his potential was only like 85 or something like that. But I got him to 92, I was like, wow! And that's only in 5 seasons! Maybe it had something to do with I was training him every single training session he was in. I didn't once take him out. But unless he got injured, he only got injured like twice, I think. Which, considering how you can sometimes get random injuries, this is pretty goddamn good. Yeah, he didn't get injured too many times. The current mode was with Liverpool. Ooh. And I did loan Ibe out. I play him only in the cups, as I'm doing here.
Yeah, the goalie was booted to the spot there.
So, it can't be because he got first team football, because he didn't. Like, the only time he played in the league is if he asked to play. Because he thought he was on good form. You know, those random messages you get to your inbox. Players from time to time. Or, if I'd already won the league, I think sometimes I rotate. Then I decide to rotate the teams at the end of the season. That's normally what I do. Well, I like to do that because it then gives some of the fringe players or the younger players a chance. And that'll be what I'll do in this career mode once I've secured the Serie A title, but that's not going to be for another couple of episodes. Well, results pending, of course. I mean, if my opponents today drop more points, then I'll win the league sooner. So, go ahead there, Milan. Of course, unfortunately, this is not a league game, so 3 points are not on the line here today. But the advantage going into the second leg, I think is
coming in now.
Still 0-0.
To clear the danger.
Stark! Ah, oh, god damn it! I mean, this guy may have the same surname as Iron Man, but he has no Iron Man. But that
It's with De Jong. Kuchka. That will be a free kick.
He trips me and they get the free kick. Right, interesting refereeing there, ref. I give that a 0 out of 10 for being utter bullshit. So well done. And you're proper referee. They always get a 0 out of 10. They're always bound to miss something.
Bounced away from him.
And that extends to real life. Referees as well. Sorry, I was just telling my dog to shut the fuck up. Because he was barking. I don't know what he did here. But, not interested in having that over my recording. Best luck for him.
Paolo De Cecchi.
Shut the fuck up. What is that, really? Come on, come on.
It could be a chance!
Stop hitting it as straight at the keeper! Why do they all do that? Like, placing the ball is an option, you know? Not place it in a corner.
Cuadrado. Oh, in goes the cross. That's proper clearance.
Please don't the danger zone. Yes, it is.
Put them in the lead.
Stark.
Great work by the goalkeeper. The ball is his and he's made sure he's protected it.
He's still no iron man.
That's half time. The first leg of this.
Ow.
Bit of
sparring, Alan, do you think, to this point? Bit of
the Coppa Nazionale. It's been a good first half of the semi-final. And we'll want to see something similar in the second half. Teams really are giving it, as you would expect, absolutely...
Murphy. Ball gets taken off him right at the crucial moment where I was about to shoot. Oof, God damn it. I... Son of a bitch! Alex in the right place at the right time. Man, what a dick. I mean... He didn't know anything about it. He was backing up. Maybe he did. I don't know, maybe he intended to block. But the shot.
And on the first 45 minutes for this new club, how do you
it looked like he had absolutely no idea what was going on. And then just got fucking lucky. Which could easily be the case as well. So
Bonaventura. Milan ready to make the change. Well, you can see what he was trying to do, but the pass...
Straight at the goddamn... The MAC Milan player, goddammit! Stark. Or Shadley, who... For some reason, is this far forward? If this leads to goal, no, it's offside.
Bonaventura. Ignacio Abate. Nunes.
Stark.
And that will peter out that attack.
Come on, where is this rapid pace you're known for?
Mario Balotelli. Bertolacci.
I mean, god damn it. Stark.
Another turnover here.
Come on, Ike. Come on, Jordan. There's Ike. Bahouli! Oh my god! Antonelli got the block of a lifetime He may have just got himself a new contract at Milan and right there for higher wages for that guy. He may have saved this match. On another block, like, was it the same guy as all? Morphe.
Lost his marker cleverly.
Off and Toli again. I just over the bar. No. Maybe I should have passed that instead of shooting it.
Bate.
Guess that's no good to me now. It's no good to me now because I don't have. Well, I don't have the ball in the position and I can't go back in time.
There is some backup for him in this position.
Stark. Yeah, Coleman, I'm sorry. I should have passed it. I don't know what I was thinking.
Zapata. Luca Antonelli. Alex. Bonaventura. It is. 0-0 here. 5 minutes left for one side to get a winner.
Coleman. Afraid.
Jeremy
Mullins. Gone. Come on, Coleman. No! Yes! Bahuli!
Wilt at this stage of a game, and he is wilting. It's an inspired interception.
It's a corner. How do I tell Buffon to get his ass to the box?
That's a corner for Juventus. Is a cheap piece of play to give the ball away like that. Jeremy Menes.
No! It's a nil all draw. Second string couldn't do it. Should I have made some subs?
Coppa Nazionale. Semi-final, first leg. Juventus nil. AC Milan.
I'm starting to think I should have made some subs. Anyway, 25 points is the gap between me and Milan currently, but they have the game in hand. So, it may as well be 22. Actually, you know what? None of my business. The window is closed, so they can't sell him. And by the time the window is open, I'll be gone. So, I don't care. Let's see. If results go my way, I might only need 3 more wins in the league. And this is one I need. Of course, it's gonna depend on what Milan do in their game at hand. But I'm gonna have to make it as difficult for them to catch me as possible, game in hand or not. I didn't even look to see if they were playing today. That's how much I don't give a shit. It's not about them, it's about me.
He starts. He was man of the match last time out. And just one out-and-out attacker in the lineup. He clears the danger. Pogba.
Pogba. Yes. Already puts me 1-0 up inside 5 minutes. That's the clinical finishing that the second team obviously lack. Already with his 8th goal of the season. 6 of those for me. 2 he scored it.
That has opened the scoring.
1-0 here. Sulu. Who and boy. He doesn't that look like a good signing.
Pinilla. Referee showing how he's going to officiate this match.
Wait, what happened? A free kick. What did I do? Live. Panucci on the line. Oh, but straight into the hands of Gianluigi Buffon, the legend himself. And I lost it.
Successfully done.
Great tackle by Isandro. And all they get is a corner. And it's once again into the hands of Gianluigi Buffon. Let's get rid of that. Oh, Dybala, get there! Dybala, get there!
And they will play from the goalkeeper now.
I'm used to the person five tackles stop up here. Unless I did that. I could have easily taken out the keeper there. I'm glad it's not 2001 anymore, because I remember back in the old FIFA games, if you tackled the keeper, you get a straight red card. No matter what, even if it was a small challenge, it would still be a red. It was always a straight red, which was weird.
A fair way away from home.
Yeah, they are, and you know, as we know, psychologically it has an effect, so we'll see if they can cope with that today.
FIFA 2002 World Cup game was the first game I remember it in. I didn't know it was in the game. I accidentally tackled the keeper or when I went to slide him to stop. My player. I take out the keeper. I'm thinking, okay, it's going to be a card. But no, it was a red.
South of danger there with that clearance. Referee points for a corner. Well, that's.
I mean, another I would understand if it was a bad challenge, but you know, it's standard slight tackle. I mean.
A real tussle between the
two. It was a tackle. I did take him out, but in real life, the tackle would never be a red card. You know, only yeah, really strict referee would send you off for the foul in real life.
Luca Cicarini.
Unless you were already on the yellow, because then it would be a red card. It was definitely a yellow. I mean, like, I could see how he gave it as a red, but no matter what you did, it was always a red card.
A massive run of victories that they want to extend today.
Because they fixed that. So, you can tackle the goalkeeper to your card's content now. Well, it'll still be a yellow, but. I try to stop shy of tackling the goalkeeper.
Raised the bar, particularly for their own supporters. And they're probably not over content with the way the team have played in front of them today. There's plenty of time in the second half for them to produce their very best. How frustrating is this for the other team trying to get the touch of the ball? Pinilla.
got his shot off now.
Never troubling the goalkeeper.
I think in one game, in one of the career modes I've already done, I think it was the Mönchengladbach career mode, but I think in one game I accidentally tackled the keeper. Nothing was given, and the keeper went outside the box. And he wasn't penalized for that. Yes, I fouled him, but he also fouled by going outside the box. I don't know, was that the Mönchengladbach career mode? Do you guys remember? My memory is terrible, so the fact that I remember that at all is saying something. It could have easily been my off-screen career mode.
At the start of the second half. Gomez. Luca Cigarini. Carmona.
Pogba.
The Caribbean.
And shoots!
What the fuck? Stupid goddamn computer. For damn near. You're scared the shit out of me. Berardi.
I think that's a good performance, isn't it?
First scored the opening goal. Oh. Ah, I should have gone for an over the top back snap. Versus that ball. My mistake.
Don't
mind. Anderson. He's got two players in the box. Ferrati. It's 2-0. Oh, wait, that's Ferrati. I was expecting Berardi to be in that position. He's back here. It's Ferrati's second goal since joining the event. Does he tuck it in? Not as good as his first goal a couple of episodes ago. But a very crucial goal doubles my lead. Thank you very much. It's Marco Verratti. Anderson.
Well, whistle's gone. Free kick.
Quickly. Suiso. Berardi. Yo. Ah!
Well, you thought there was only one winner there, but in the end it was the keeper.
Well, there's going to be an alteration there.
We're making a substitution. It's not going to affect me, so I don't care. Well, Verratti. Ooh, imagine if he scored again.
Bellini. SD Caribbean.
Some options now for the pass. Can they do it in these closing minutes? I wouldn't be surprised to see the
opposite. Second attempt. That ball has cleared through. He's offside.
On the shoulder of the last defender.
That is why he knew he was picking up his run. He didn't have to. He was offside. Brilliant. Get that out of here. Well, ball. Oh, that ball. He's only got one defender to beat.
This is a good opportunity.
Forced him out wide. Berardi. God damn it. Suiso. Oh, forces a fantastic save from the Atalanta keeper. For the young Frenchman. I think he saved it with his thumb. Anderson.
Este Garibia.
Someone's hurt. Is he actually hurt? No, he isn't. Of course he's not. What is it with this game? You've been trying to make me think players are hurt.
On EA Sports, very soon, a date for your diary.
This Malo.
Atalanta, they'll be facing Lazio away from home.
Well, you know that the break is definitely on.
Dybala!
Straight at the goalkeeper.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Well, headed pass then, and a shrewd one.
Pogba. Dybala. Penalty! Yes!
Goes in from the penalty spot.
A very silly challenge by the Atalanta defender, where he took Dybala out. Even if he did win the ball, it is still penalty. Carmona. Carmona gets a bit of karma. No? Sorry. Dybala to wrap up the 3 points. Bury it. Yes, he did. Was there any doubt? 3-0. No. Oh, 3 more points. And if results go my way, I'll be within 2 wins of the league title. Oh, yeah! 26th league goal for Paulo Dybala. And every one of them has been crucial in getting this league title.
Carmona. Gomez. It's a real tussle. The referee's kept on top of this game.
Foul there. Herbert. It's not going to matter. The referee's going to blow for full time any second now. Oh, Chile clears. You might as well blow up, bruh. There we go. There's the full time whistle. Oh, a comfortable win. 3-0. Oh, now let's see. Did Milan play? They did, and they're drawing 0-0 with Sassuolo. Ooh, if that stays the way it is, because that's 2 dropped points. It's 2 crucial dropped points from AC Milan. They have an absolute howler.
One.
Come on. Or maybe even Sassuolo can get the win?
Fiorentina 1.
Let's see what that means for the league tables.
See. It's not telling me anything. It's telling me I've secured a Champions League spot. I don't care. I want to know, did Milan get anything from the game against Sassuolo?
In 4th, Napoli with 50 points. In 5th, Lazio with 46 points. In 6th, Chievo Verona with 43 points.
What does the league table look like?
With 42 points. In 8th, and falling,
Roma are 2nd now. Milan must have dropped points because they're down to 3rd. They wouldn't be in 3rd if they hadn't dropped points. So yes! See, 32 points ahead of Napoli. Ooh. So I'm 28 points clear of Roma and Milan. Milan still have that game in hand, so they could easily reduce it back to. Wait, did they lose? Because they were 25 points behind, correct me if I'm wrong. Did they lose to Sassuolo? Did they actually do that? Oh, tell me they did that. Yes, they did! They lost! They freaking lost with a bunch of scrubs! They lost! Yes! And there's their game in hand. It's against Chievo Vinola. Oh my life, yes! Oh, things are going brilliantly. They have a game in hand, but they lost a game. Brilliant. That was really going to help. That aim of getting the league title wrapped up. perhaps in the next episode. But to finish off this episode, I'm going to show you the simulation of the second leg against Lyon. Of course, I'm leading 4-0 from the first leg if you didn't see the last episode. You can play. Actually, it's past the 13th now, so let's quickly have a little cheeky look at the fixtures. They lost again! No freaking way! Milan lost again! But Roma won. So Milan have played their game in hand, and they are still 28 points behind me. But Roma have closed the gap to 25 points, but they should have a I should have a game in hand over them now. This is going. Everything is coming up Corey. Okay, Milhouse. Fuck Milhouse. Yes, indeed. Milan are still. So it's 25 points with 10 games remaining. If I win 2 more games, that league title is staying with the old lady. And the next 2 games are to, no, and Sassuolo. Wow, I could win it against the team who pretty much helped me win it. The irony, the cruel, cruel irony of this game is freaking hilarious. It's sometimes, it is really. Here we go. So, if you're wondering, I only saved because just so I don't get any injuries. But this second team, it didn't matter. And PSG beat Chelsea, so I'm guessing I'm playing them next. Because, of course I am. Despite the 2-0 loss, I'm still through because I beat them 4-0. So, they only pulled it back twice. So, 2,
Juventus 0.
Here, Owl. Yeah, you were terrible, but we lost. I'm blaming you. You asked me to play and you didn't get the job done, dumbass. Right. To wrap up the... So, I want to see. Did I get PSG in the next round? No, Benfica? I avoided PSG. Okay, so in the next episode, I have 2 crucial games, and if I win them, the league title is mine. Do not miss it, because it could be the biggest and the most crucial episode of this career mode. Thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed, smash the like button if you did, subscribe for more content, and until next time, I hope you all have a very, very